In the last video, we accessed our database from within LibreOffice Calc and grabbed the data into the spreadsheet, and from that we produced a scatter plot. So in this video, we will produce a bar chart and use a query for doing that. So in the first place, I will make a new sheet here in the LibreOffice Calc. Place that we have a clean space to start from. So here is the original sheet with our scatter plot, and now I make a new sheet with the informations that we now will like to have and to visualize. I said we want to use a query here. So in this data source navigator, I can see in my database also queries here. And I've already created this sexes versus materials query. And if I click on it, we can see the results here. If we don't have this query yet for the information we'd like to have, we can always go here to right-click on the specific database and say edit database file. And then we get to the LibreOffice base program, and here we can create a new query. If we do so, we have to save this query and also have to save the database so that everything is refreshed and up to date. But we have already created this query, and you saw that in a previous video. So I will skip that and use this query that's already existing here and have the information here. Okay, now in the same way like we imported the data from the individual tables, we can also import the data from a query by right-clicking up here and say copy, and go to the sheet and say paste. With this, we have the information about the different sexes and the materials here. Now we want to have a bar chart that represents the number of different sexes. For example, let's start with that. And to do that, we have to count the occurrence of individual sexes here. We have to do that by using a pivot table. So we have to start with either data pivot table create. You can also use insert pivot table. It's actually the same. So I will go here, and now we get to this dialog, which asks us if the current selection here includes the data that we would like to use. Yes, that's fine. We could also directly request information from data sources, but we will not do that. We stick to the data that we have already imported here. Okay, and now I have this pivot table dialog here. And what we like to have is the sexes and the names of the sexes and the number of times these sexes occur. So I drag sexes.name to our road fields. And now I can just drag any of these other informations here. I stick with sexes name and drag it to the data fields. But we don't want to have the sum of the data of the sexes names. We have to want to have the count. To do that, I double click on that item and select count here. Okay. And by pressing here, okay, I have this pivot table here, which gives me male, female, and female question mark, and not determined here in numbers. We can easily turn this into a plot by selecting these informations here. Not the total results, but only these informations that are actually coming from the database and are not derived. So count of sexes name and the numbers here. And now again, I can insert a chart. And this time also we have already the chart that we would like to have, a column chart, which is actually a vertical bar chart. It's more or less the same. Usually you would call this also a bar chart, but here they insist of calling it a column chart. And again, we could go to next and give it a title, for example, number of sexes, site Miskovice. And we could also rename the x-axis or give it a name or a label and give the y-axis a label here. That probably doesn't make sense to add count here. And click on finish. And now we have here our small, I have to click one time outside, move that here, our small little information about the number of sexes as a bar chart. We could also, by double-clicking it and changing the chart type to, for example, a pie chart, by just clicking here pie and OK, and now again we have the percentages or the ratios of the different sexes in our burial site. I strongly recommend to use a bar chart because it gives you more information than a pie chart. And you could also make this relational, but this is not will not be the topic here. And also it has additional qualities. I will show you that in a second. So we make a new pivot table from our original data, but this time we also include the material names here. So again, data, create prio table, current selection, that's fine. And now we use sexes name again in the row fields, but this time we add in the columns the material.name and also dragging this here and saying count. And now we get not only the different sexes, but also categorized into the different material classes by clicking OK. Now I can see here the male females and here the different numbers of artifacts that are represented here. So again, by selecting this and inserting a chart, I can create a column chart and I can just rephrase some of the information here, the title and subtitle. Well, I will not do that because we did that before. I just click on finish. And what I now have is, let's say, the material spectrum in the individual grave types. And I can see already here that, for example, amber is much more present in the female burials than it is in the male burials. So with that, we have already more information visually represented. And you kind of could do that with a pie chart, but it would become much less readable than it is in this situation here with the bar chart. Okay, that was it for now. And in the next video, I would like to show you how we can evaluate if the number of amber burial items in the male burial is really significantly lower than in the female burials.